One of the keys to this basketball game down the stretch, if Danielle's going to drive like that, State's got to have somebody back to prevent the fast break.
2 minutes left to go in the game. You're looking at the game clock. Both teams have three timeouts left. Here comes the pass inside to Smith. It's a block by McLeod. She goes again and gets it this time. 12 second half points for Charlotte Smith, and it's a one-point game for the Wolfpack women as we go under 2 minutes.
We said she needed to make a stand, Reese, and she's certainly done that.
She didn't score in the first half, but she has here. Shot comes off long, and Smith goes up and gets the rebound for Carolina. Has 7 rebounds.
Look Carolina, for a set play, Reese.
Carolina can take the lead for the first time since the first half. Rebound to McLeod. That was one of the weirdest plays that I've ever seen. Everybody stopped as if a whistle had sounded, and the ball just came right into Sarah McLeod's hands. And now NC State is going to spend its second timeout of the game. They will have 2 left, and Carolina has 3 left. Another reminder, we've got more basketball coming your way on Saturday afternoon, February 27th, when the Wolfpack women will meet the other team that tonight is tied for first place in the ACC, the Virginia Cavaliers. The Cavaliers this week ranked 11th in the nation. Carolina is ranked 14th. Now, Kay Yao, we're looking in her huddle on the sideline, and Coach, what you think?
Well, I think I might like to be there a little bit, Reed. These are the fun situations for coaches. I'm sure what Coach Yao is telling her team are multiple situations. She's talking about offense and how they want to score, specifically this time down four, but also talking about defense on the other end, what they're going to do. She's going to give them plays for what happens if they score and if they don't score. And what we have, I'm sure.
Look at Sarah McLeod again.
See the pass inside and a great block by Sarah McLeod. But there's the stick-to-itiveness that lady has, Charlotte Smith, and going back and putting the ball in the basket and putting Carolina in a great position.
That shows you when you block a shot, your work is only half done because you've got to stay with it and go get the loose ball. And Smith beat McLeod that time after the block. State shooting 44% this half. Carolina shooting 40%. The rebounds are virtually dead even. 19 for Carolina, 18 for State. State with 6 turnovers, Carolina with 3, and Danielle Parker's layup won't go. And Charlotte Smith comes down with another rebound. That's 8 for Smith. Crawley with 4 goes against McLeod. Back out to Smith. Now to Sampson. Sampson gets the bucket. 11 for Sampson, and Carolina leads it on the basket by Tanya Sampson with 30 seconds to go. Parker takes it to the hoop. Whistle foul, Charlotte Smith. Well, you talk about the cream rising to the top. Tanya Sampson had done absolutely nothing offensively here in the second half. She had made her first 2 three-pointers of the game, missed 7 shots in a row after that, and then made a 2-pointer. Right now, Carolina decides to spend another timeout. So when we come back in a minute, each team will have 2 timeouts left, and Carolina has a 1-point lead.
See, Jill Sudworth making a great play for Carolina and bringing them back, making that steal, and then getting the assist as Tanya Sampson hits a layup on the other end.
Sampson's got the last 4 points for Carolina. Charlotte Smith, who has had some kind of second half for the Tar Heels, at 12 second half points.
Danielle Parker needs to back off the line, Reese. You know, she's standing there, just needs to get loose, back off the line, just hit these free throws like she does in practice.
Made one and missed one at the free throw line tonight and has 11 points. Rebound, Tammy Gibson blocked by Smith. Parker has it, she goes up and gets it. State has a 1-point lead. The shot clock is off. Carolina with 2 timeouts left. Sampson's got it. Jump ball belongs to State. 13 and a half seconds left to go.
A lot of time left in this ball game, Reese.
And Carolina's going to ask for the timeout. So we've got a timeout with 13 and a half seconds left, and we'll be back in a minute to wrap it up. Here's the key play as Parker puts it up to give State the one-point lead. Now let's see what's going to happen as NC State has the basketball. You're looking at the game clock. The shot clock is cut off. Hancock to try to inbound it to Kaczynski and back to Hancock.
Surprised that nobody's...
Well, they couldn't catch Parker. I think they wanted to foul somebody other than Daniel Parker, and then when Parker got the ball, they couldn't catch him.
Reese, looks like they were a little confused with their matchups as they were, as State was taking the ball out of bounds. In that situation, hey, you want to stay with your girl as soon as the ball's passed in bounds, foul her immediately.
We want to congratulate our legs players of the game for North Carolina tonight. Sylvia Crawley with 16 points was the leader, playing a lot of the second half with four personal fouls. And for NC State, it's the gal at the line, Danielle Parker. Parker with the go-ahead basket that gave State a one-point lead, and now the free throw that gives State a two-point lead. And again, Carolina takes a timeout. They have none left. This is their final timeout. So State with a very comfortable two-point lead at 57-55, but with 3 points. And when you look at Carolina, Carolina is a three-point shooting team. They have taken 365 three-pointers this year and made 119 of them. That's 32%. And they've got Jill Sudreth, who can shoot it. They've got Tanya Sampson, who can shoot it, and Stephanie Lawrence, who can shoot it. So this is a big, big free throw coming up for Danielle Parker to make it three.
If she hits it, it's certainly going to put State in good position. But what Coach Yao's talking about right now, she's saying, Danielle, just hit this shot. But defensively, this is what we're going to do. Let's play a couple people in the backcourt. Let's make Carolina dribble so they have to use some of the clock by getting the ball up the court. Look for that to happen. But also look for North Carolina to bring the ball down court, maybe run their wings wide, get the ball down early, hit a crossing wing for the three-point shot.
It's 57-55 in favor of NC State. Danielle Parker goes right back to the free throw line, working on the second of two tries. She has 14 points tonight, a 5'6 senior from Clinton, North Carolina. Three-point State lead. We'll let you just sit back and watch this one. There's no need for us to tell you what you can see.
You can see Ashley's going to play down court a little bit, try to make Carolina dribble the ball, not let them have that long pass.
Gibson goes for the interception, and Sampson commits her fifth personal foul. So Tanya Sampson has fouled out of her third game this year, and she leaves with 11 points. North Carolina State trying to go to 12-10 on the season and even their ACC conference record at 6-6. Now remember, the first thing that we said tonight as you look at the State bench on the sideline, Debbie, was home court advantage.
Well, you got to win them at home because you don't rarely, you rarely get to win them on the road. And State's just been an excellent team when they played in rounds.
Gibson is 0-for-2 at the free throw line tonight. She has 4 three-pointers. And now she has 15 points. And State can breathe just a little bit easier. They have a 4-point cushion with 3.7 seconds left.
That's the icing on the cake.
16 now for Gibson. And Sarah McLeod, the tallest player for State, will challenge the inbounds pass. It comes picked off by State. And that's it. State will win it by 5. The final score at the Coliseum, State 60, Carolina 55. For everybody at Mustin Sports, I'm Reese Edwards. For Debbie Leonard, good night, everybody.